Hello, folks. My name is Jim Lyle. I'm pleased to be presenting Dallee products today, and I'd like to thank you very much for tuning in or signing on or however you got to our presentation. We brought some of the interesting things that people kind of overlook, perchance, when they think about electronics. This boxcar, we start here. This boxcar has what we call FRED, flashing rear end device, which took the place of cabooses on freight railroads in this country. This way you can replicate that without having to run a caboose. FRED is this product here. You see he has the LED hook to him and a connector for a 9-volt battery. FRED is also here. FRED is inside the television station with the receptionist secretary, by the way. She's in there too. And the flasher is up on the tower. Well, this took about 10 minutes to accomplish, and the only challenge was in keeping the polarity straight. And if you have a red pen, that's very easy. Just two pieces of wire, ran them up to the top. We took the LED off of the board, maintained our polarity, put it on here, hot glued it a couple times. Kids loved it at the train show. You're probably noticing that we have the lighted cars up here. We've been chuckling about these cars because you may not see light in this car at all, but this is the way this car was manufactured. The lighting in this car draws 0.425 amps. Now, if you put six or eight of these cars on a track, you're going to put a definite draw on the power system to the locomotive. You go to the lighting in this car, it draws 0.15 amps, one-third of the power. The light is very visible, and the light definitely represents what is in railroad passenger cars of today. The fluorescent lighting run from the locomotive, what they call head-end power. If you move down to these cars, which represent the pre-Amtrak cars, these happen in Pennsylvania, you'll notice that the light is warmer. That is because these lights were incandescent primarily. They were run off of batteries. They were powered by generators underneath the cars. They were independent of the locomotive, and if they were on long enough, the lights went out. Both are available. They are 18-inch strips. That one is cool white. This one is, you want to just throw that away. And these are the 10-inch strips in this car. The 10-inch strips are $34.95. The 18-inch strips are $54.95, plus tax and shipping. We brought our E-units. Lionel guys are going to recognize this little guy. Flyer guys are going to have nasty words to say about this little guy. These will replace that. This is the 2-amp. This is the 4-amp, which should handle almost all of your flyers. And this is the 10-amp. The 10-amp is a relatively new product. The 10-amp is shown in this chassis with two CAN motors. The 10-amp would run two open-frame O-gauge motors and could run more of that, but you want to amp out the draw before you would commit to it. Because once you destroy electronics, you have destroyed them. Some of the other items we brought Momentum 1. We showed you Momentum last fall. We had it in a black box, starting and stopping an American Flyer locomotive. This is Momentum. If you go to the website, www.dallee.com, you'll not only see Mo 1, but you'll also see a lot of different ways that Mo 1 works in with station stops, stops and goes, things like that. We have the opto sensor. The opto sensor is an optical switching relay system. Basically, it works off of light or the absence of light. The website explains it better than I can right here, right now. But this is a very reliable, very solid product. There are several large display layouts that have loads of these on them. Those same layouts also have our various relays, DTs, DTTs, DTLs, etc. In fact, the S-gauge layout in this museum is running on S-gauge starting relays, and in the 16 years I have been involved, not one has been replaced, to my knowledge. We also have the strobe, which is a flashing, brilliant white LED that you would put on a school bus if you're detailing vehicles on a layout, on a caboose roof. We have the Mars light, which would go in a headlight position in a locomotive. We have the flasher. We brought the flasher along because this is just an old tried and true favorite. This will run your flashing crossbucks, flashing lights on vehicles. The 12 VPS is a regulated power supply, which we recommend to operate any of the relays because it gives them clean, dependable, controlled voltage. The adjustable power supply module, which has some things in common with the 12 VPS. This is being used, I am told, in late model locomotives with electronics. This takes the place of some of the failing electronics. You'd want to consult the website for that. Then we have the beacon up here. If you can pick it up, the beacon is like a revolving beacon in that it gets bright and dull, bright and dim. And it's been doing that since we set it up at 9 o'clock this morning. Fred, in this situation, has been on this battery for at least 12 hours. I'm sorry, make that 20 hours. It's been on that battery for at least 20 hours, and it's every bit as bright as it was when we hooked it up. One more thing about the lights in the cars, the strip lights. Gentleman here asked if they could be separated. Yes, they can. There are separation points on the strips. You can run you can separate the strips and run lighting to a separate piece, but you need to run it from the regulated power supply. The regulated power supply is what makes the light strip work, what makes the light strip dependable. And along with the light regulated power supply, you can also install what we call a super cap, which will extend the lighting length that the light would stay on after power went off. Going through switches where you might lose power, you'd never see the lights blink because the super cap will keep the lights lit. It comes with an extension cord that we plugged in here so that we wouldn't lose it. And as I said, the regulated power source, there are definitely cheaper LED lighting strips. They don't have regulated power, and they have a life expectancy issue. Once again, the website is dallee.com, D-A-L-L-E-E. I'd like to thank you very much for tuning in. And you can contact the website, you can contact the Dallee factory, you can contact the Dallee dealer, and we'll do our very best to take care of you. Thank you very much.